So you've heard about the HubSpot Remix tool and you want to know how to use it? Well, in this video, we're going to run through how to use the HubSpot Remix tool, set up a couple of scenarios, and then get you into a position where you know how to use it. So let's get into it. All right, so in this tool, we can do a bunch of different things. And in this scenario, in these examples, I'm going to step through a couple of different types of examples that you can use. By and large, you should have a pretty good framework in regards to how to use the platform altogether. But this is a really great tool for you to use and test and experiment with. I will put a caveat to say that when you generate AI content, it should never be 100% what you're going to publish. It should always get you to about the 80% mark so that you can finesse and add your own sort of tone of voice or nuances to your organization as well. So please do not use this tool and publish things straight out of the gate. Make sure that you are adding your personal touch to it. Now we'll use a couple of examples here today. Another caveat, if it's not ungated in your portal at the moment, or you don't currently have Content Hub and you're currently looking to potentially use Content Hub, reach out to us in the comments below or email us at mbh.co and we can get that ungated for you. But let's dive in and get cracking on it. So this is the UI that you'll find for it inside HubSpot. It can be found underneath the content tab and you can go down to the Remix tool. When you click on the Remix tool, you'll see a couple of templates that you can use out of the box, but you can also see a couple of the different types of saved remixes that you'll have. Now, a saved remix is a really good example of something that you'd like to do over and over again. Now, when you start become familiar with the content remix tool, you'll probably use these saved remixes over and over again. So let's go at the very, very top here and click on start remixing to start our very first remix. All right, you can sort of see here, this is what we can kind of see where we've got get started by adding remix. I want you to start by always adding what it is about. So this one here is going to be our HubSpot how to example. You'll notice from the past screen, it's all just untitled, untitled, untitled. You want to get into a really good habit of being able to label stuff to make sure organization is key. Okay, the first thing that we go through is obviously we want to add our content. Now, adding the content as we go through there, it's what we're going to be drawing from and extrapolating from. So the Remix tool, in short, is that we give it a piece of content, and what it does is it creates more content based on the content that you've inputted. So the inputting content that we've got here is the stuff that we're gonna generate stuff from. Now, you can see that there's four opportunities for here to remix as well, the input types. We've got videos, web pages and text, audio and image. So video got announced at Inbound 2024, so it's a new addition. But I did hear rumors about PDFs and a few other input types that are going to be coming through as well. In this instance, what we can sort of do is potentially use the web page and the text for this example. We could use a video remix as well if we want to, but we might do this on a different video just as it might differentiate between different businesses. If we click on web page and text, we're going to have basically three different areas or four different areas that we can kind of pull from. We can pull from some of the content that we might already have on our blogs. We might want some new text as well. So we could copy and paste something in here as well that we want it to remix. So take from it and create more content from it. Now we can add a new document and file. And this one was specifically brought up at Inbound that we can now put in a PDF or something along those lines to remix that tool. I believe also things like PDFs on PowerPoint presentations, etc. Realistically, again, this is a really good opportunity for you to experiment as well. Or if you or someone you know has content and you would like to remix it up and make it your own as well, here is the opportunity for you to do so as well. So in this instance, what we're gonna do is look at some of our existing content. We've got some great content on the Neighbourhood website, so I really wanna pull in from that. Over here, I'm gonna drop down and I am going to look at some potential blogs that we've got. So this one here is called 10 Lead Nurturing Strategy Tactics to Increase Your Marketing Results. Great. So I'm gonna click on this and I'm gonna add the content, and you'll see that the content gets added to that block, but what next? Well, now I wanna make sure that I tell the content remix tool what content it should be making out of that content. A lot of content words here, let's work with me. So what we wanna do is we wanna press this plus button and click on this. Now, The sidebar is gonna give us a bunch of different options. You'll notice that SMS is locked for us in Australia. It is unavailable for us, but at the time of this video, or if you're watching it, it could be available inside your portal. So please also look at that as an opportunity too. But at the very side, we can create Google Ads. We can create audio files. We can create blog posts. Sounds pretty cool. We can create images. We can create brand new landing pages. We can create emails to be sent out to our customers. We can create social posts, and we can also create website pages. So just to show the example of what we can do here, I'm gonna go ham on it, but I need to give the AI some prompts in regards to what to generate to make sure that it's in the, not only the tone of voice and in the brand of what we do, but also lean into what we want it to do. And you'll see this in just a moment. So first and foremost, I would like to create a blog post. I would like to create one. If you wanna create 9, fill your boots. I don't know, we don't have enough time on this video to go through all different 9. But I might also wanna go through and I might wanna create social posts, and I might wanna create 2 of those. Again, you can select them all if you want. You can select 1 or 2. I will sort of say, start small and then grow into it. Obviously, you don't want to create all this content. While you're getting familiar with this new tool, start small, get used to it, get to understand how it kind of works, its strengths and weaknesses, and then you can start at scale as well. So in this instance, I want to create 1 extra blog post out of this topic, but I also want to create 2 social posts as well to drive people to this topic, to this specific content as well. So I'm gonna click on next, and this is basically where it's going to go, and I need to sort of lean into giving the AI direction in regards to what to create. So here, what's the objective? So basically, my thought process in this is the more context you can give the AI, the better. So obviously speed through this quickly so that you're not bored with me typing quickly. All right, so here I said I want to inform readers of how important it is to create lead nurturing in their organization and what the best first steps are to make it happen in their business. So a little bit different from what I want to create. This is the most effective, but this is probably leading to like, what is the first steps? Now I want to create a long, email. I don't want to create any generated images in this post. We've got Canva here. We want to make sure we sort of keep it in the look and feel. Feel free to do it. It's a bit hit and miss, obviously, in the AI world with imagery. So fill your boots with that one if you want. Okay, so here we've got our social. So basically, I want to post on the company's LinkedIn page, but I also potentially want to do it on my own personal. So here, I want to give readers. All right, so here I want to give readers an idea of how we can do it for their organizations, but also be a thought leader as well. I'm going to paste this into the other one as well, because I want it to sort of, I guess, match that same. I don't want it to be the same. You shouldn't be posting and replicating the posts on all channels. So what we're going to do is try to make these a little bit different on each of them. But I do want to give them an idea roughly on how we can do it for their organization as well. All right, so we've got the attributes in there as well. We're ready to go. Now look, this is why I'm saying if you go ahead and create 9 blog posts, you're gonna have to do this 9 times. And the best practice is to make sure each and individual one from a point of view perspective and an objective is all different as well. So we'll go through and we will generate this with magic. All right, so you can see that depending on how many extra pieces of content that you'll be generating, it's gonna take a bit of time. So for example, if you are generating 9 blogs, 2 landing pages, a couple of socials, a few Google ads, all that sort of stuff, it's gonna take a bit of time. You can see that, okay, well, it's literally probably been 20 seconds since I pressed the go button. It's created a blog post for me and it's created 2 social posts. So the question is it any good? So let's go dive in. So what we wanna do is we wanna go view all the content. And we've got the starting content, which was this blog, which we can see on the right-hand side here. We're gonna look at, okay, so this is the second blog post, this one here. If we click on this one here, it's created a quite an extensive blog, this one. Boost sales with effective lead nurturing strategies, the power of the market in today's fast-paced digital marketplace, the competition. It's, by and large, created a, a, an article that I think that I could read and learn from, that's definitely for sure. Again, I will preference the first part on what I sort of said, where you really do want to make sure that you don't just post what you have, you want to make sure that you finesse. It'll give you to about 80% of what you need, and then you go ahead and put your human touch to it as well. So this is really great. From face value, it looks really good. If we look at the social posts, so if we look here, ready to transform your lead generation game in today's fast-paced marketing world. Nurturing leads is not just essential, it's an art form, yada, yada, yada. Curious about how we can help organizations elevate its lead marketing? Let's chat. So it's heard the part in which it says that we could do it for different organizations, but I lent into the fact that I wanted to be a thought leader as well. So, you know, imagine a seamless process where every interaction builds trust and guides them through the buyer's journey. You can tell that it's actually tried to lean into that. I think its emoji game is pretty strong, in my personal opinion. I wonder if I could write, hey, just ease up on the emojis. But this is exactly where I say this is where where the human element comes in to edit it as well. We'll have a look at the other post as well, and it shouldn't be the same. So the other one here, we've got the Neighbourhood Co, and then we've got the LinkedIn. It's not just about generating leads. Want to see how we can help organizations make meaningful connections. So it's kind of said the same thing, but not really. It's included the hashtags. It's eased up on the emojis on that one, which is pretty good. So what I can do here is if I'm ready to rock and roll, I can save this and edit in app that'll bring that content into the social tool, and bang, I can schedule it out, edit it a little bit, and you're good to go. This goes the same as well with this blog post as well. I can save this and edit it into the blog tool. Before wrapping up we go, one other thing I would like to mention here as well is that you can start to create, if you love Christmas, you're gonna love this, you can create a Christmas tree of more and more content. And what I mean by that is to say, for example, that I now want to use the AI-generated document to create more content off that specific topic, you can do so with these extra plus buttons at the bottom as well. So much like we did in that first instance, we can start creating this Christmas tree of different topics and different subtopics and basically build out a content tree. I'm coining that word, a content tree that we can use to go ahead and really think about how you want to communicate to your customers and potential future customers and prospects as well. If you're a first time using this tool, my recommendation would be to just jump in there, play with the tool, mess around, make some mistakes, and really try to convince some of the people that you work with, whether you wrote it or AI wrote it, and I think you'll be in for a bit of a surprise. So the tool itself, if you don't have it in your portal, you can reach out to us, or otherwise, reach out to a HubSpot employee that you might know and just ask for a trial, and jump in there and have a bit of a play. Well, that wraps up on how to use the content remix tool inside HubSpot. We covered how to use it, how to create more content from it, how to optimize it, and also how to create more content from that. If you need more information about what we've spoken about today, there's a PDF in the description below that you can download and share with your friends. But that's it from me. Happy HubSpotting.